Good morning. So we're at the Wild Horse Casino Resort, just east of Pendleton, Oregon. And we are headed up the old Immigrant Highway instead of taking I-84 up the mountain. We filmed that. Yeah, I think we're going to North Powder, roughly, where we get on the Elkhorn Scenic Loop Highway. We're gonna go hiking up there somewhere. And it's supposed to start raining by like 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. Figured out, and I watched the window. Yeah, all the reservation gas stations have biodiesel, and luckily we don't really need to fill up now, because we're gonna wait. Hopefully the sun doesn't ruin this video, because never went up the road this way. We always took I-84. This guy did not even look. He just backed straight the hell up. Jeez. Get away from him. just clueless, I swear. Interstate going up is pretty steep, so that's why I'm really curious as to how steep this is. Looks like on the map it has a lot of switchbacks, more than the interstate. So in Sumter, up way up in the mountains this morning, I saw it was like 35 degrees an hour and a half ago. Which was really cold. We're gonna go there one of the days we're here. Oh, St. Andrew's Mission down the road there. It says since 1847. I wonder if you can tour it. Would be neat. Oh, I can see it. Yeah, I bet you can. We'll have to try and go there tomorrow when it's raining. That would be neat. Steps yesterday, just walking around the campground, the resort, Pendleton, Walmart, and there's a pheasant I saw just go off the road. Wow. To the west. Storm front is coming. So the interstate is still way below us. So this might not be that bad if we're already this high up. We haven't even started climbing yet. Four-mile hikes we're going to try and do today, round trip. Each one's 4 miles round trip. to the Richmond hikes to a lake, so that should be fun. Then when we come back, I think we found a 12-mile one, maybe, or 10. And there's a bunch. There's so many of them. That's the problem with Google Maps. They don't show every hike all the time. Every trailhead, I should say. And we haven't been able to find a hiking book yet of the area, because nothing was open yesterday. There is no cars on this road. I don't think anyone uses this. They don't really, on the interstate, they don't put signs for it. You just figure, why would anyone come on this road? I noticed it on the top following the interstate, and I thought it would be fun to see. So then I figured out you can go up the mountain on it. First time we could actually use it for as long as we wanted to, because we were hooked up to sewer. Because the first time we used the trailer, we did not have a sewer connection. So I tried to shower, but I had to be quick. I didn't want to fill our gray water tank up. So it was really nice. To the top already. Oh, it's really neat to look down and see the interstate. Trailer shower, they actually did something really nice. You have the wall of the shower, and behind that, at least where the faucet is, there's another wall. And we have a little drip leak where those connectors are, but it all runs into the shower tub because of that. Whereas the old RV we had was not like that, I'm pretty sure. And we did have a drip there too at one point. but it basically would go out on the floor into the RV. So I like how they constructed the trailer. Definitely better. Like, they thought of that. So to fix the trailer little leak, I think we have to take the cover off where the faucets handles are. So I have a guy coming out to do a yearly maintenance thing. I'll have him do that, I think. Just in case I'm wrong and it's more involved than I can do. I don't want to tear it apart. And it doesn't do any harm right now. I just turned the water off when we left so it doesn't slow drip, because we're hooked up to the city water, not using the water tank. Yeah, we are almost at the top. You can see the cell phone communication towers in front of us. That was not bad at all. Definitely, I didn't feel it was as steep as the interstate. Unfortunately, I wouldn't bring a trailer up here because I don't like the no shoulder and the severe drop-offs, but with a car or truck, it's fine. Oh, this is neat. Get to the trees soon. Some clouds. Wow, it is still brown here. Not had much rain, I don't think. That will change this week. Under the freeway a few times and kind of go back and forth as we drive on this old highway. Oh, and I wonder if I was supposed to go under the road right there. Not paying attention to the sign. We'll find out. We're still on Immigrant Road, so we are good. Is the route of the Oregon Trail, because on the interstate it actually says Old Oregon Trail Highway on the Google Maps. Wow, there's some nice little cabins / houses up here, it looks like. There's the interstate in front of us, you can see. Wi-Fi at the campground is free, and you don't need a password, and it seems very fast, which is awesome. Access the rest area, but you can from the highway because this is it, it's coming right up in front of us. I think it's a really nice rest area, too. We've never actually stopped here, though. Yeah, it looks pretty nice. Oh, wow, they have a dump station off to the right here. Don't even have to go into the parking lot. It's closed, though. So there's a scenic viewpoint, and I think that's still the road we want to be on. Not really sure. We're gonna, because the road goes under the bridge, or the freeway too. Let me, yeah, let's go this way. And if we're wrong, I can't imagine we're wrong. Turn around and cross the freeway. To get under the freeway, there is a single lane road, only 12-foot 6-inch clearance. So I can't believe it's the old highway still. Okay, I think this is it. Google Maps says we're still on the old Immigrant Trail highway. So Le Grand is 32 miles. I am pretty sure we can't take this all the way. I was hoping to see some trailhead parking or signs by doing this road. Because I think there's something back in here. I thought that. On the interstate, there's no signage for it though. I'm also curious as to whether there's campgrounds back here. Oh, it's called the Old Oregon Trail now on Google Maps. Thank you. think we'll drive into the viewpoint parking lot. We should be able to see the view just driving around in a circle. I think we gotta get out. We're doing a photo op. Off we go. So it is 64 degrees. Kind of windy. We're going to be in the trees hiking though. So. Oh my gosh, there's some potholes here. You could probably camp here overnight. And that's what I want to find out. Like, there's a spot you can just pull forward and camp. You could have camped in that circle. Looks like there was places people put their tents down, actually, in the grass. Totally camp here. For free, if you're passing through. That's why I like getting off the interstate. There's no sign saying no camping. No one's gonna bother you. There's probably a lot of van people that come here in the summer, I bet, that know about this place. Camp here. Definitely a bumpy road. We need to just go ahead and buy an Oregon State Park pass, I think, for $30, $40. interstate it is. I guess we'll... I think it's right off. I think you can see the campgrounds if you pay attention when you're on the interstate. We'll check it out. Side of the interstate for a while now. That would explain the name. Matches the road. Oh, and there's a cell phone tower right here, so you'd have cell service. That'd be cool. Yeah, this might be a fun place to come back to someday. Trail picnic areas. Campground to the left. So tent camps, we're gonna check out all of it. Tent camps to the right. Looks like trailers, RVs to the left. Oh, this would be a great place to stop when you're on the interstate just to have lunch. Use the bathroom. Oh, okay, so the straight ahead is the horse camp group tent. So this is the tent area right here, right off this parking. Or no, this is not a tent area. This is the picnic area. So I guess the only tent area down here is the horse camp and the group camp. So we're gonna go to the actual part of the campground now, where they have everyone else, I guess. Yeah, this is really nice. So, picnic tables. The bathrooms are super clean now, probably. See if we got water. There's any trails here though. I didn't see any signs for trails, which is too bad. So that would be neat. Oh, there's a picnic area on this side too. Bathrooms here. It looks like they're plus toilets, probably. I don't know if we'll go up to the building. We might. We're gonna check out the campground first. We gotta make some time today. And that's really what I care about is the campground. Because if the campground is no good, we will not come back here except to eat lunch, maybe. Oh wow, you can rent cabins here. So must be one way. It's telling me to go left. Oh yeah, this is nice. They have travel trailers here. I see some vans. And there is full hookups, it looks like. I see water, power, and I'm pretty sure possibly sewer in some of the sites. Not all the sites have them. Oh, I wonder if that was... Yeah, there is sewer. I see a sewer. So there are full hookup sites here. I can totally camp here sometime. If I would have known that, we could have almost camped here this time, but it's alright. I like where we are. We're centrally located. Yeah, this is super nice. So not all the sites. It looks like the sites on the outside of the loop have the hookups. Inside do not. Feel you see full hookups at state parks very often, especially in like places like this. You know, it's pretty remote, you know, up in the mountains. It's a lot of work to put all this in. It would be really neat if we found a trailhead actually along this road where you can hike. That would be cool. There was a trail going to the left that I just passed on the road, but there's no sign or nothing. I have no idea where it goes or if it's in, what it's for. Oh, and these are cabins you can rent. That's pretty cool. Yeah, if we ever come back here, maybe we might stay here instead, potentially. Yeah, it's cell service, it looks like. I think AT&T and Verizon work here. The nicest thing about where we are though is the convenience. You know, we can get to Walmart easy, we can get anything we need really easy. Here you're driving 30, 40 minutes to either Le Grand or down to Pendleton if you need something. So yeah, looks like the outer, again, it's the outer spots to have the full hookups. They have the bigger driveways for the most part. Oh, showers here. Wow. Payphone. And there is some type of trail. Oh, it's called the Cabin Loop. So we'll have to look this up on the internet to make sure there isn't an actual hiking trail that actually goes somewhere. Because that would be really cool. We could stay here for sure. I wouldn't say they have a ton of full hookups. There might only be a dozen. Maybe 15, 20 at most full hookups. So definitely the off season is the time to go. We're gonna get back on the highway. Let me check this out. It's like at the board, they don't have the price up. You have to get up and read the fine print. Well, we found one place so far today. And I would feel fine with our trailer. I think there was maybe, I don't think I saw anything over 30 feet there. But at least, you know, 25 feet or less. If you have a 25 feet or less trailer or RV, you'll be fine. It's usually the limit at the state parks for campgrounds. Oh, it smells really good. You can smell the pine trees. mansion. 3 miles. Yeah, and I've come through this point before, and I could have stopped here. Instead, I would keep driving once I got home at like 2 a.m. Because like once you get past here, you just don't find things necessarily. At least if you're on the interstate. Which is where I was. I found a ton of places in Central Washington off of the interstate lately to stay. City, it's 70. So if we go there one of the days when it's raining, it looks like it might have 2 rain days now. Or if we go hike down there, we'll definitely take the interstate the whole way. That way it'll only take us an hour or a half maybe to get there. No, that's as far south as we'll go. There's gotta be a hiking trail there, I would think. Why would you put a campground somewhere where just a campground and no hiking trails? I think that would be weird. Unless the springs are the focal point. And I wonder if they're hot springs. That would be cool. We didn't go to the community building to find out. But I'll look online. Their website. It's already 8:45. Get down the road. Basically, we can hike till 6 o'clock, no problem. So even if we don't start till 10, we still have 8 hours. We can do a lot of hiking. I was really hoping there was hiking along this road, too. Because I look on the gazetteer, thought I saw stuff farther back off of the road, but I haven't seen any signs for anything driving on ahead. Wow, that's a giant Oregon DOT building. Outpost for their snow equipment. They have their own little quarry there too. Meacham. Tuesday at that little store there. Wow, so the train tracks going through here. They had 4 tracks at one point. I think it's down to 3. like that would have been a fun one too. Kind of parallels the interstate. Semi there. I don't know if he hit a deer or what, but he messed up the front of his truck big time. Whatever it was big, but I don't think it was a car. for, honestly. Anymore. Track. looking forward to having fun tomorrow. So I think what we're going to do tomorrow is go to the really nice museum they have on the resort land, and then have fun, and then we'll drive to Pendleton and go to the county museum, historical museum, I think it is. Oh, there's a snow park ahead. Wow. And then we need to go to Walmart again and get some shelving units for the trailer. Should be down in this valley in front of us. I don't think we have more than like 10 miles to get there. Max. Spring Creek Road now. I probably need to make sure that this is gonna get us somewhere. Yeah, I don't think at this point. Yeah, alright, so we gotta get on the interstate. So, right here. Oh, this is one of the scenic roads to Pilot Rock. And I wanna do that someday. It's like the farthest north road through the mountains, scenic road, 43 miles to Pilot Rock. And I thought it was paved, but it might not be. So, onto the interstate. I always wondered where that access point was. I knew it was somewhere in the area. Yeah, we will not try that today, because Pilot Rock back to Pendleton is a long ways. I feel like it is. I could be wrong. It's kind of confusing when you get down on those roads, back roads. Thank you. true, because when you look at Google Maps, you can't find any trailhead reviews. I just think it's just odd. I think why I don't understand it. Going through all that national forest, and there's just that one state park is it. And they got the diesel I like. Well, that was Wild Horse Casino to the Grande on the old Oregon Trail road.